Minnesota School of Music. In consideration of our performers and guests, please take a moment to turn off your mobile devices. Also, take this moment to locate your nearest available exit from the theater, which may be different from the entrance you used. Thank you for your cooperation.
Virtual audience members who are joining us from near and far via our live stream. As many of you know, these new professional live streams that we've had for symphony concerts this year have been a wonderful way for many of your long distance friends and families to tune in. I think at our last concert we had family or audience members, I should say, tuning in from all across the world, several countries across the world, as well as across the nation. And so we're grateful to you for making that possible and all our donors for helping us with that. This is the final week, I should say, of our school year activities, and it's been a busy few days. We are looking forward to spring festivals at Orchestra Hall next week and seeing many of you there as well. We are preparing for summer activities, summer programs, summer orchestras, and auditions, of course, coming up. We appreciate you spreading the word about those opportunities to any young people that you know who could benefit from the GTCYS experience. I want to recognize all the parents and family members and friends who help make the GTCYS experience possible. Just by being here tonight, you are showing your support. By spreading the word to other families about GTCYS, you are showing your support. I also want to highlight two additional opportunities that are coming up in the next week or two for you to play your part. There's an insert in your program. We have an online auction that is live as of this evening. There's information about that on the insert. You can kind of bid for a cause, if you will. We also have our orchestrating opportunities benefit at Orchestra Hall in about 2 weeks' time. And our symphony musicians will have the wonderful opportunity to perform with Minnesota Orchestra's principal clarinetist, Gabriel Campos Zamora. And we invite you to join us for what will be a wonderful evening of music and raising support for GTCYS programs and scholarships. In the meantime, tonight, you are in for a wonderful performance right here at Tevin Concert Hall. We're delighted to welcome Philharmonia West to the stage. Students, I look forward to hearing you shortly. And then we have two fantastic soloists, Owen Boyd, a bass player in symphony, and Joyce, Zhao on violin. They will knock your socks off. And we're excited to hear them play solo as the concerto competition winners this year. And I also want to thank our concerto competition sponsors, House of Note and Schmidt Music. So thank you again for being here and for all you do to support these wonderful young musicians. Enjoy the concert, and please join me in welcoming Mary Sorlie. Thank you.
Thank you. Us. It is an incredible time of year. As you see, we have amazing talent in our midst, and it's not just those two who play so fantastically. It's this entire group, and as many parents know, we are just full of amazingly talented high school students, and some even younger than that. It's an amazing time of year because of the journey that these musicians take. Each year, symphony explores a full symphony, and it's usually from the Romantic period, and it really entails a lot of dedication, a lot of hard work, a lot of practicing. You parents who have been attending all the concerts have heard this symphony kind of in bits and pieces, but not the whole thing. And I feel it's really important for us as musicians to learn to play these big pieces and to really be able to take listeners like you on a journey. It's really an incredible thing to study a piece throughout the whole year, and what is even more incredible is if you were at our first rehearsal in September, would you ever think that we'd be playing this piece? No, you wouldn't. Except I have incredible faith that these guys work unbelievably hard. And so we take this journey and we grow and we work and we practice and we really get to know a piece from the inside out. Tchaikovsky's Sixth Symphony was the last symphony that he wrote. As a matter of fact, he died, I think, 10 days after conducting the premiere of this work. Obviously, it's a symphony that is called the Pathétique, and that kind of came about later on, I think, because knowing how Tchaikovsky, well, what happened to Tchaikovsky, and also the way the piece ends. This is not your typical symphony, which is a fast movement and then a couple, maybe a dance, and then a slow movement, and then a kind of rip-roaring finale. The rip-roaring finale happens in the third movement, and then we have an unbelievably expressive final movement, which we haven't played yet, which we haven't performed. And it is, after the journey that we take in the first three movements, is just really heart-wrenching, and the way the piece ends, the way the piece ends in silence is really important. I was saying to the students today, is that silence at the end is such an important part of the music as well. So we are very excited and are really well prepared, I think, to take this journey and to take you along with us. Tchaikovsky's Sixth Symphony, the Pathétique.
Thank you.
Thank you.